The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. We first call to mind our sins. I confess to
Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned. My thoughts and in my words, what I've done and what I failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, and all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters,
pray for me
to the Lord our God.
The mighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
God, restorer and lover of innocence, direct the hearts of your servants toward yourself, that those who have you have set free from darkness of unbelief may never stray from the light of your truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Some who had come down from Judea were instructing the brothers, "Unless you are circumcised according to the Mosaic practice, you cannot be saved." Because there arose no little dissension and debate by Paul and Barnabas with them, it was decided that Paul, Barnabas, and some of the others should go up to Jerusalem to the apostles and presbyters about this question. They were sent on their journey by the church and passed through Phoenicia and Samaria, telling of the conversion of the Gentiles, and brought great joy to all the brethren. When they arrived in Jerusalem, they were welcomed by the church, as well as by the apostles and the presbyters, and they reported what God had done with them. But some from the party of the Pharisees, who had become believers, stood up and said, "It is necessary to circumcise them and direct them to observe the Mosaic law." The apostles and the presbyters met together to see about this matter. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
I rejoiced because they said to me, "We will go up to the house of the Lord." And now we have set foot within your gates, O Jerusalem.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
Jerusalem, built as a city with compact unity, to it the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
According to the decree for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord, in it are set up judgment seats, seats for the house of David.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle
Spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, I am the true vine. My Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit. Everyone that does, he prunes so that it bears much more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who doesn't remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire. They will be burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, it will be done for you. This is how the Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
word of God, we present our prayers to the Father.
For the Church, may the Holy Spirit direct each of us in our service to the Lord and to one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our word.
For government leaders, may God give them wisdom in working to protect human life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all whose hearts are burdened by sin, and for those who struggle to trust in God's mercy and forgiveness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those of us gathered here, may the grace of this sacrament transform us in the image of Christ's love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in the Ukraine, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Veronica Dunkel and all who have died, may they soon witness the full glory of the Lord in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For any intention you wish to offer, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Guide us and help us. Inspire us by your word and your teachings and the Holy Spirit to bear fruit. May your fruit show forth in the world around us and the people we touch. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Sacrifice yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O God, restore in love of innocence. Grant that we always may find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, all times to claim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you yet most gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life in the halls of heavenly kingdoms. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall. They become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and willingly with his passion, he took bread and giving you thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, save us.
The Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together, Francis, our Pope, Lawrence, our Bishop, the clergy. Remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with all the apostles and saints who please you throughout the ages, who may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, keep us always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you send your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sin, but the faith of your church, graciously grant her peace and unity. In accordance with your will, you will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of our Lord Jesus be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Share a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. How blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. when the shepherd calls his sheep, they know and heed his voice. So when you call your family, Lord, we follow and rejoice. You satisfy the hungry heart with
let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange by which we have been redeemed may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Tonight is the holy hour at 6 o'clock with confessions as well, and benediction at 7 o'clock. If you people, somebody out there is still thinking about coming back to church, you know, tonight's confession, and then Saturday and Sunday, we'd love to have you back. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
God blessings upon you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying your life by God. Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.
Have a good day.
Thank you, Father. You too.